Welcome to the AV team. The AV team is responsible for providing the Sunday gathering with everything that appears on the big screen. This includes images and sound, so obviously this is an important job. Members of the AV team serve on a rotating basis. When it's your Sunday to serve and you're scheduled for the first service, you need to arrive at Desert Sky at 6:45 a.m. to help unload the shed. If you're scheduled for second service, please arrive by 10 a.m. Before you serve for the first time, make sure you shadow someone else to get a better idea of how to set up, break down, and run the computer. When you set up, grab the square table from the shed. That's the one we use for AV. Set it up to the right of the outlet along the back wall. Give yourself enough space for a chair. Next, find the clear bin in the shed containing AV equipment. It currently has a green lid. Bring it to the table. Next, find the monitor with an oval base. It goes on the AV table too. The power cord for the monitor should always be in the mesh pocket on the back of the monitor case. Remove the monitor from the case, plug in the power cord, and set it on the AV table. The computer should be in a small black waterproof case. Remove the computer and place it on the table behind the monitor. In the clear bin, you'll find most of what you need. First, locate the extension cord for the back table. It's rectangular. Go ahead and plug it into the top of the outlet and place the rectangular section beneath the table under the right side next to the soundboard. Next, find the black video transmitter and place it on the table with the front facing the stage. The transmitter looks exactly like the three video receivers, except we used white tape for the transmitter, and you'll find the word transmitter on the back. All cables have been color-coded to help you know how to attach them to the equipment, which is also color-coded. The equipment tape is usually placed where the cords go. The monitors all have yellow tape, the transmitter, as I mentioned, has white tape, and the computer has green tape. Go ahead and find the white power cord for the computer. It should have green tape. This cord requires a little pressure to make sure it's in all the way. You'll find the power cord for the transmitter in the bin. Just look for the white tape on the end. You'll plug an HDMI cord into the transmitter on one end and the computer on the other end. Look for an HDMI cord with white and green tape. You'll also find a special cord that goes from the computer to the monitor. It's coated with yellow and green tape. In the bin, you'll also find an audio delay device. We keep these cords attached because it's difficult to know where stuff plugs in if we disconnect it. This device delays the computer audio so that the video and audio are in sync. The video is slightly delayed already because of the wireless connection. This device will plug into the extension cord too. The 1/8 connection goes into the computer audio. Look for the headset logo. And the 1/4 connection will plug into the soundboard. Use tape to secure the extension cord, transmitter HDMI cord, and the audio delay device. This is a good time to place the keyboard on the table. Before you do, open the battery compartment and remove the antenna for the keyboard. Plug this into the computer. In a small clear bin the pastor brings from the office, you'll also find the mouse. Place it on the table after you open the battery compartment to remove the mouse antenna. Plug that antenna into the computer too. While you have the small bin open, find the recorder and place it on the sound table for the sound tech. This is also a good time to find the small black rectangular device we use for the hearing impaired. You'll find this in the large clear bin. And place it on the sound table next to the recorder. The sound tech will plug in the computer audio, the recorder, and the hearing impaired device to the soundboard. All cords should be plugged into the rectangular extension cord except the transmitter. We'll do that later. Next, set up the screen. In case you forget how to set it up or take it down, instructions are actually on the underside of the carrying case lid. Place the screen on the left corner of the stage. There's a black cloth that attaches to the back and a By Faith banner that attaches to the front. Both use Velcro. You'll find the By Faith banner in the large white box on wheels we affectionately call the coffin. You'll need to get a desk from the room we walked through to get to the shed. Place it 4 squares and about 5 inches from the steps. Arrange it so that the projector, which will be on the left side, will point at the center of the screen. Place the notebook from the clear bin on the left side of the desk to help angle the projector high. Place the projector on the notebook and attach the power cord to it. The power cord should always be in the projector case. You'll also find a remote control in the case. Place the remote on the desk too. The remote helps to properly power down the projector later. Place one of the 3 video receivers on the right side of the desk facing the computer. You'll find a short HDMI cord to attach the projector, which is coated blue, and the receiver, which is coated red. Use tape to secure the cord. Find a power cord for the receiver, which should be coated red, and plug it into the receiver. But don't plug it into any power yet. The pastor will speak from the center of the 4 rows of tables. The tables to his left and right get monitors. Turn chairs on both tables around for the monitors. The ideal placement is the chairs closest to the center. Each monitor has a power cord in the mesh pocket on the back of the carrying case. Plug them in. Both monitors also get receivers, which you'll place on the table facing the computer. Find the power cords for the receivers in the large clear bin, but don't plug the receivers into a power source yet. One monitor has a built-in stand, but the other one uses a separate stand. Because the monitors are slightly different, one gets a pure HDMI to HDMI cord to connect it to the receiver. But the other monitor, the one with a circular base, gets an HDMI to DVI cord to attach it to the receiver. Look at the tape on the back and you'll see the 2 different connections. The tape is also color-coded. Use tape to secure the HDMI cords to the tables. Next, place the large clocks on both monitor chairs. At this point, you'll need to find the proper orange extension cords. First, find the orange extension cord attached to a black and yellow spider-like extension. This extension goes under the projector desk. The orange cord plugs into the outlet to the left of the steps. You'll plug the projector and receiver into this later. You'll also plug a shorter orange extension cord into the spider-like extension and run that cord to the monitor to the right. This extension cord should have a short double extension attached to it for the monitor and the receiver. You'll plug these in later. Finally, you'll run one orange extension cord from the outlet to the right of the stairs all the way to the monitor on the left. It should also have a black double extension on the end for the monitor and receiver. Now, slide the projector cover to expose the lens. Turn on the projector. After you've done that, plug in all receivers and monitors. Go to the computer and plug in the transmitter. While you're waiting for the video screens to indicate that each monitor is receiving a signal, use tape to secure all the extension cords you just used. If one of the screens doesn't have a logo on it, you may need to troubleshoot. It's probably a poor HDMI connection. Once you have a logo on all 3 screens, press the power button on the upper right side of the computer. Once the computer powers up, use OASIS, all lowercase, as the login. You'll have to turn on the keyboard and mouse, however, before you can type. Now you'll need to set up the light stands. The one on the left plugs directly into the wall, so set up the stand very close to the outlet. You'll also need to plug the power into the lights before raising them. As you raise the lights, make sure they're not so high you cannot adjust them individually with the help of a chair. The stand on the right goes at the end of the curtains, but inside the last bar. For this set of lights, you'll need to run the white extension cord from the outlet to the right of the steps to the light stand, making sure the power cord is placed on the inside of the curtains, away from where people walk. Turn off the NPR lights on both sides of the stage so you can properly adjust the lights. With a chair, position 2 of the lights on each set of stands to the worship team, being careful to get everyone on stage without placing any light on the screen. Position 2 of the lights on both stands to where the pastor will stand, recognizing he may move some. The lights should barely overlap so you can get more range. On the computer, open up ProPresenter by pressing the icon. Find a light-colored slide with writing and click it. Go back to the desk to adjust the screen. You should make sure the writing is clear and the image takes up the entire screen without bleeding over. Also, you will probably have to adjust the projector legs up or down to make the image even. Before you do that, however, make sure the screen is even and the projector is positioned at the center of the screen. As the worship team rehearses, it's important that you click through the ProPresenter lyric slides as if it's a dress rehearsal to confirm the slides are in the correct order. If not, let the worship leader know immediately. At times, you may need to rearrange slides, duplicate slides, or even disable slides. When you shadow someone, ask how to do these tasks. Make a quick sound check when you have an opportunity to ensure we can clearly hear the video embedded in the message and the pads for the worship team. After the worship team finishes rehearsing, or at least by 15 minutes after the hour, make sure you play appropriate background music. Generally, we play Spotify worship music at a low volume. The sound tech should be the one who adjusts the volume, however. If you're no longer checking slides for the worship team, make sure the intro loop is running. It provides basic announcements for upcoming events. You'll also click on this loop immediately after the service ends. You'll need to finish talking to your friends 6 or 7 minutes before the service begins, so you can be at the computer ready to begin the 5-minute countdown at exactly 8:25 or 10:25. Once the countdown completely ends, use the mouse to click on the first slide of the introductory song. If there's a pad, it should begin immediately. Then use the arrow key to move to the next slide, which should have lyrics. Generally, you'll use the arrow to move within a song and the mouse to click from a song to the welcome or from the meditation to the next song. In other words, within a unit, use the arrow key. When moving to a new unit, use the mouse. You're in charge of the songs and the welcome slides. The pastor takes care of the message and the announcements. So for the message, you just need to click on the first slide of part one and part two. The pastor does the rest. You'll also need to click on the intermission video and the first slide of the announcements. It's important you click on the first slide of the message, which is usually a bumper video, within 2 or 3 seconds of the object lesson or preceding song ending. This bumper video provides a buffer while the pastor gets ready to start. He won't go up until it's nearly over, so make sure you start the video quickly. The most important part of your job is moving the lyric slides during the songs. This is also the most difficult part of your job. It's natural to wait until the team is finished singing all words on a slide before moving to the next slide, but that's not helpful. Here's the truth. People think and read much faster than they speak or sing. So before a slide is over, people naturally want to know what they should say or sing next. So here's the rule. By the time the congregation gets to the last word on a slide, you should already have the next slide up. I know that seems crazy, but they know the last word on the slide before they say it. So they should never see the last word on a slide while they're singing it. If they do, you're moving too slowly. From time to time, in spite of countless hours of practice and rehearsal, the worship team sings a song differently from the lyric slides. When that happens, remember, this is more art than science. Go with your gut. Does it seem they've skipped ahead? Or maybe they're just repeating a slide again? Do your best. That's all we ask. And don't worry about all those people turning around who mistakenly think you're the one making an error. Just relax and guess where they're going. By the way, because the computer plays sound, you may notice a sound issue before the sound tech does. If so, let him or her know immediately. You're our fail-safe. That's it. That's all you need to know. Welcome to the team.